Scorpio, it's me, Stormy, and welcome to 2020 and welcome to your January 2020 forecast. And we're going to take a look at what the planetary movements are bringing in this month to your attention. Before we jump in, if you do want to join the forecast marathon that we're doing, 12 different astrologers on astrologyhub.com, we're talking about 2020. I'd love to see you over there. You can click in the description box down below and get signed up if it sounds like that is up your alley, okay? All right, Scorpio. So this month, as we look at the board, you can see, first of all, this is a heavy third house time, right? We've got this major planetary alignment of Saturn and Pluto coming into conjunction. We've got the lunar eclipse happening. Uranus is going to come out of retrograde. Mars is going to leave your sign. So it's a busy time, and it's all built around supporting this particularly heavy Capricorn energy that we've got going on in your chart, okay? Now, the third house, Scorpio, is all about communication. It's about the mind. It's about the smaller mind. We're learning things, our patterns that we've got going here, our methods of thinking, limiting beliefs that we have here. It can also be a space of siblings, learning, teaching. All of these things in the form of communication is what's happening down in the third house. Now, with such a heavy third house that has been happening, because I do want to point that out, coming into 2020, you're coming in with what was, but now you're making different decisions. You're taking different attitudes and different actions towards some things that you've already been seeing and dealing with. And this allows those things to get fresh life and fresh movement, okay? So you've seen some of the things that you're already working on. So let's say, for example, in this heavy third house, you've been working on the space of limiting beliefs or something like that, something that has kept you from moving forward. Let's say that you've got conditions that you're dealing with. Do you have PTSD and you've been learning to treat that, how to work with that, how to care for yourself through those things? Have you been teaching people about things of the mind like PTSD, limiting beliefs? Something like that in your third house could be definitely work that you're going to continue this month. But let's jump in here and talk about what's happening by D. Right at the beginning of the month, we see Jupiter and Mercury traveling together in conjunction here in this third house. Now, Jupiter is the planet of the bigger mind, the higher mind, right? He wants the big picture of things. So he's a big planner. We love his energy. Now, we've got Mercury, who is the energy of the smaller mind, the details when we're trying to get into things, we're trying to learn something like that. So as these two are traveling together in conjunction, what it tells me with Jupiter and Mercury here is there's some kind of big plan that is looking to play out in this third house area of your life. Now, could this be a project? Maybe you've got a project that's going on. You're getting information around that in some way, shape, or form. Are you continuing to learn and gather wisdom in a big picture way about what's happening in this third house area for you? A couple things I'm thinking as well, because this is the third house, this could be, are you planning a big trip down the road? Are you planning a trip down the road? Because it doesn't have to be that you're crossing oceans. You know, are you planning to go see a family member or go tick off something in your bucket list and you're saving money, you're getting a plan together for that or something? Here will definitely stimulate your thoughts and your communications in this third house area. It could also be a place where maybe you're getting your learning and teaching plan together or a studying plan together for yourself moving forward. Now, January 3rd, Mars is going to move out of your home sign. He's moving out of domicile and the comforts of home and moving into the energy of Sagittarius, into your second house. Mars lighting up the second house space. First of all, let's talk about what they're about. Mars, action, energy, movement. My boots are on the ground. I'm actually doing something, right? I'm not just thinking about it or vibrating with energy. I can actually be moving my body and doing something with this. In the energy of Sagittarius, it could be about expansion. I am trying to make money, second house, while expanding out in some way, shape, or form, sharing information. Sagittarius wants to gather information and share information. So maybe, is that what you're doing to make money? Is that what you're doing to up your self-esteem? Are you in action with these things? Are you traveling? Is this actual boots on the ground? You are traveling, you are seeing something new and having that experience. Either way, Mars here is going to bring the action to the table of new experimenting, new ideas, new people, different cultures, different ideas. One of the other things I do pay attention to is that yes, Mars in the second house can definitely help you make that money, help you expand the way that you're thinking about something. Remember, we've got your third house stimulated, but we've got Sagittarius in the second house, which is about big picture thinking. So this could be expanding how big your thought life is, how big your thought processes are. But Mars in the second house as well could be an indicator that you want to pay attention because maybe you're spending more money. And maybe you're spending more money on your learning, Sagittarius, from your third house. Because everything is going to be built to try to support what's happening in your thinking, communication, learning house over here, okay? So just keep in mind that Mars can mean you're throwing out some money, and as long as you're paying attention, I think that that's okay for you to spend your pennies on whatever you'd like to. When we get to the 8th of the month, Jupiter is going to come into conjunction with this transiting south node. And this is important to note and to know about, I think, because it means that the 8th and the 9th are not the best days for planting seeds of intention. Instead, they're about reflection because Jupiter is about pure wisdom, right? He's wisdom, he's expansion, he's the breadth and the beauty of the things that we've learned. Coming into conjunction with the south node, this is from the past. Right? So these energies today working together on the 8th are going to be about the past. You're reflecting on, okay, Scorpio, over this last year, what has all of this massive amount of third house energy taught you? Where are you still unthinking, relearning new information? Where are you seeing you need to learn new information? From the past, are there old communications you need to continue to disconnect from? Because that south node is saying, let's disconnect, let's detach. These things, we don't need them anymore. They're not serving the soul anymore, right? So we need to detach from them. Where do I need to detach from something that I learned when I was old, when I was younger? And now that I'm older, I see that I have space to learn something new, which is going to be better suited, right? It's like outgrowing the small minding and allowing it to have a bigger picture. I also think that this is a reflective energy of, do you have content? Do you have communications to share with people? And in some way, you've been held back. I mean, has your thinking held you back? Has your lack of understanding how to write that book held you back? And on this day, you get to reflect on it because soon it will be time to launch out over here. Speaking of the launch out time, we've got the lunar eclipse happening up here at 20 degrees of Cancer. Okay, this lunar eclipse is still our full moon for the month. So it says we need to end something, we need to acknowledge something, or we need to make an adjustment. So there will be a shift or a little bit of a disruption in the force in this particular ninth house area. The ninth house is publishing, broadcasting, expansion, travel, the expansion of your mind, faith, right? Believing something bigger, right? Ethics, the law, they all fall in there because they're the space of the bigger mind, bigger content to be taking on from this third house. With the balance of these energies, this full moon could certainly be putting you in the position to say, we need to rethink the way we're doing this project. We need to rethink some training. Maybe we need to get in order to make money, right? We need to rethink, maybe should I actually be taking that class? Should I go ahead and invest in that class so that I can expand this higher mind, especially with that transiting north node there, right? Whatever it is, it's ultimately trying to support you here, but it's going to come through the lens of the ninth house. Now, if you do have a legal situation that's been going on, the lunar eclipse over the next 6 months could certainly bring that thing to an end, which would be great. I would highly suggest if you needed to begin a legal situation, do it before the end of the month, before the energies get foggy. The eclipse is also, you know, it's a time where disruptions come to the table. And if that's the disruption you need in order to maybe get out of a contract, resolve something with a contract, that would be an energy I think would be okay to jump in there. Either way, we're looking for a lot of head-heart balance that is also happening in this particular energy as well. One other thought that I'm having about that lunar eclipse is if you have been writing, if you have been trying to publish or broadcast or get something out there, over this next 6 months, this lunar eclipse will help to open this space for you so that you can get your work out there should you move out of your own way to be able to allow that to happen. On the 11th, we've got two things happening. First of all, we've got Uranus, who's over here in Taurus, just your opposite energy, coming out of retrograde. Now, Uranus has been retrograde since 2019, and it's in your seventh house, which is all about relationships. But they're conscious chosen relationships. You chose these people one-on-one to be in your life for some reason. They fit some purpose or some ideal for you. These are not the relationships you were just thrust into. Nobody saw them coming, right? You have chosen here. So with Uranus here retrograde, he's been going over these relationships in your life to include Scorpio, the relationship of you with you, right? We have to shed our skin and grow into something else occasionally in life. Evolution, you're the sign of evolution. So certainly this has been pointing you to looking back over who you've been. How have you showed up? How have your behaviors impacted your relationships for the positive and the negative? It's not all bad. It's not like Scorpios are just out here being these terrible, mystical, scary energies. That's not your gig. You're an evolutionary energy, which is deep, but there's power in being a Scorpio. There's beauty in being a Scorpio, especially if you can see how it's impacting your relationships. So Uranus has said, Scorpio, we got to innovate. We have got to innovate. We can't keep showing up how we were. We need to innovate these relationships. How can you show up in a way that's more productive to your relationships? How can you show up in a way that's more productive to you? How can you show up in relationships that's more productive to making money? Do you need to refresh some relationships that you've got going on, right? Now, as Uranus is moving forward, he's going to give us the wisdom to understand what we need to change and what we need to keep over here. I'm telling you, if there have been relationships in your life, and I include your YouTube and social relationships, if you just can't stand listening to a certain astrologer, you just feel like every month they're not bringing value, if you can't stand that cooking channel anymore, let it go. Innovate. Allow Uranus to show you where you can have some of your time and your energy back, because that's the intuition here. But also, welcome some of the maybe different relationships it brings into your life. We're talking a lot about your learning, your teaching, and your expansion here. Maybe you're needing to make those relationships online to learn and study online, or to sell online and allow this Mars to bring value to your table, like some money. Thank you very much. Okay, when we get to the 11th, 12th, just depending on where you live, we'll see the Saturn-Pluto conjunction happening here. Now, because Saturn and Pluto conjunction is such a slow evolutionary process that's happening, and it's happening in your communication sector, what it can feel like, Scorpio, is loss. Like it feels like something's not there, or you feel this immediate need to make some changes, right? And sometimes it comes on the heels of something actually makes you irritated, and then that's how you know you want to make those changes. But Pluto is working here as your ruling planet to say we need to evolve. We need to have a phoenix moment in how we're communicating, in what we're studying, in what we're learning, right? In how we're communicating with ourselves, our mental situation. So we need to die off in one way so that we can live in another, evolution. And then Saturn comes in here and says, cool, I'm going to mature this. I'm going to take this to the next level so that this area can succeed. This is at the base of your chart. This is sitting in this northern hemisphere. If this piece of the foundation is flawed, if the thinking is flawed, getting above here is going to be really hard. So this is an energy that can feel like maybe a project is ending, maybe a way that you were thinking about doing something, or something you were absolutely set on, like you just knew you were right, and you're finding out that, oh, maybe I want to put some different information or education in there or something. Either way, it can feel like loss in this energy. And when it does, it will be your X marks the spot, your golden ticket as to what to work on. And the rest of these energies you can use to pull in to help you make decisions and action and movement here, okay? On the 13th, Venus is hightailing it out of the energy of Aquarius and moving into the energy of Pisces. So this is going to light up your fifth house space. Venus in the fifth house, this is wonderful for love, for romance, for, you know, maybe you're out and about, maybe you're taking a class, maybe you're at the bookstore or the library and you meet someone nice. And it doesn't always have to be romance in the sense of like, oh, this is the new romance that's coming to my table. You can just really enjoy conversing with other people. Maybe you're talking about creative topics. Maybe you're talking about spirituality, healing, mental health, any of these kinds of things. Venus is going to bring a harmony to this area. If you do have children, this is nice because this can bring a little bit of harmony too. But please keep in mind that the opposite energy to Venus is still in the second house, so maybe children are a little expensive at this time as well. So that could certainly be something that you're seeing. But ultimately, Venus, if you wanted to take on a new project because maybe you changed your mind or you wanted to do something differently, Venus can also bring some financial gain with you as well. on the 16th, we get the show really moving here. Okay, Mercury is going to move on into the energy of Aquarius. Oh, come on, Mercury. There we go. The Sun is going to move. And then we're going to have the new moon happening in Aquarius. So all of this Scorpio will begin to light up your fourth house, okay? Now, the fourth house is home, family, real estate, property, your internal emotional securities. It can certainly be parents. So with all of these energies moving over here, Mercury is about original thinking. Maybe you've got to get a new idea. You know, maybe something has happened with a project. You've decided I'm going to work from home. I need to figure out how to make my home base more comfortable for me in some way, shape, or form. But another thing I think of with all the travel vibe that's been going on, you certainly could be taking this Mercury energy, especially before it goes retrograde, and getting ready to make a move or change your house around, something like that. I don't think yet it is an indicator of someone moving into your house, but certainly someone could be moving out of your house. Now, at this new moon is where we want to plant these seeds of intention. What do you want in this fourth house area, right? Where do you want to have your own independence? Working from home is a level of independence that is insanely beautiful. Do you want independence in your job? Where do you feel like emotionally you're willing to untie some thinking or untie some attachments, learn something different to gain some emotional freedom as well? So this is a really delicious energy to kind of delve into, but remember, everything's kind of trying to support the big learning happening over here. All right, Scorpios, just two dates I want to remind you of or tell you about so you can be mindful of them at the end of the month. On the 27th, we have got Venus and Neptune coming together. They're delicious. They're wonderful. They're blissful, right? They're just, it's almost too good to be true. So they really do enjoy traveling together. They're in the house of pleasure and of joy over here. So enjoy those bad boys. Eat the good stuff, enjoy the people, make out a lot, whatever makes you happy, hug on those kids, right? Whatever it is that brings you joy in this area. Now, what I would tell you is I wouldn't make any big decisions that day. They are so good that it's almost too good to be true. You may be missing some information. And then just a day later on the 28th, Mars is going to be, he's right here in Sagittarius, but he's going to square Neptune over here. So he's like, hold on a minute. You're not about to spend my money on that. He is telling you you're missing something. You're being put under tension because there's something that's not quite clear yet. So trust the guidance of Mars trying to take on this energy over here to show you and say, let me pause for a minute before I make any big decisions. Let me pause for just a second before I make any big commitments. Or let me get lots and lots of information so I make sure I'm making a decision that's not going to bite me as I get down the road and instead can be an investment that is as delicious for me as this energy likes to be on its own. All right, Scorpios, I hope you like this video, find it helpful. Please comment, share, subscribe. Let me know in the comment section down below how this manifests for you this month. I'm sending you lots and lots of love here in January, and I can't wait to see you in February. Bye, everyone.